Previously on
Trading a Pen for a Car. Is it possible to trade a pen for a car?
I am sat in the car with Sandor's watch.
Yeah!
Offered a pram and fuzzy duck slip set. Tom Sat Nav, it works, still in his box, which he's willing to trade for the watch.
This Sat Nav. Please get in touch if you would like to trade.
Now, last episode, I said if the video got 4 likes, then I would do another video. Well, we have absolutely demolished that and are on a whopping 12 likes, smashing the target by 300%. Those really are staggering numbers, and I never expected this series to be the massive viral success that it is. But there you go, good news. Also, we did have one dislike on episode 3. This isn't a witch hunt or anything like that, but if you could make yourself known in the comments so I can block and delete you from YouTube and social media, that would be great. So obviously we're still currently on William Sat Nav. Now, the problem we're having is not the quantity of offers. We're actually getting quite a few offers in, but these are all from items which seem to be on a very similar level to the Sat Nav, if not slightly below. So it's very much a case of being patient and knowing which is the right time to move, a bit like the stock market. Anyway, without further ado, here is a full roundup of our weekly offers. Good evening and welcome to the news at 10. Or should I say, the news at pen.
He got it.
Offer number one, a goldfish. This is an offer Danny has received. Apparently the seller has been quite insistent about trading, which makes me think there may be something wrong with the goldfish. Through a quick Google, it says that a goldfish shouldn't cost any more than $5. And you know, our Sat Nav is worth hundreds. It's worth more than $5. Also, you know, things like transportation, food, animal rights, they're all things you don't have to deal with when you have a Sat Nav. Offer number two. We've been offered a bike. Now, this is an exciting offer and something we are really interested in, but the trader of the bike isn't completely sold on our Sat Nav for whatever reason. They do want to trade their bike, but they don't know whether they want to trade it for the Sat Nav. Option number three, a garden hedge strimmer, or as it is simply described on Gumtree, a strimmer. The one problem I'm having is when I asked the trader, does it work? His reply was, not sure. Surely you could just test it. I'm not an expert, but one piece that really stood out to us on Gumtree's swap shop was this full body Iron Man suit. You know, it's not necessarily an everyday household item, but I like that. It makes it easier to market. This was something I really wanted to go for and I thought could be a real game changer for the quest. So I went in with a really nice message, a lot of flattery. Got back quite an abrupt response. Lol, what do I need a Sat Nav for? I'm locked in my house, not allowed to go anywhere. It's a good point. But what I would say is lockdown doesn't mean you're actually locked. You have to lock yourself in. You can open the door. I wish you all the best in your quest. Kind regards, D. You can't argue with that. I do like the fact she called it a quest. So we had some offers on the table, but we were yet to find anything that really set us alight. Until. So late last night, I've stumbled across this masterpiece. A Roman gladius, unsharpened, decorative. Of course, it's decorative. This is not something that you'd use out and about, day to day. So I've offered this Sat Nav this morning, sent out a little message explaining our journey, and the legendary owner of the gladius, Nick, he's got back to me, says he loves the idea of the quest, and is willing to trade.